Hello students, welcome to another session of Human Resource Management. In this session, we will be discussing about human resource planning. As we all know that human resource management is very important for the survival and prosperity of an organization. Procurement of right kind and right number of employee is the first operative function of human resource management. Before selecting the right man for the right job, it becomes necessary to determine the quality and quantity of people required in the organization, which is the most primary function of human resource planning. Before going into detail, let us study about the definition of human resource planning. According to Y.C. Mushell, human resource planning is a strategy for the acquisition, utilization, improvement and preservation of an organization's human resources. By this definition, we mean that human resource planning is the strategy for acquiring and utilizing and improving the performance of the employees who are working in the organization. Another definition given by Jay Kenley says that human resource planning is the process of forecasting an organization's future demand for human resources and supply of right type of people in the right number. This definition also explains that human resource planning is forecasting. Forecasting is determining the future need of the number and the correct type of employee required in the organization. Further going into detail, let us study about the features of human resource planning. The most important feature that human resource planning is future oriented. As we have already discussed in the definition that it is forecasting the number and the type of employees required. Therefore, it is based on the future requirement of the employees working or about to work in the organization. Therefore, it is a forward-looking function which involves forecasting the manpower need for future period so that adequate and timely provisions can be made to meet the needs. Next, it is a continuous process. Human resource planning is a continuous process because the demand and supply of human resource keep fluctuating throughout the year, and planning has to be viewed according to the needs of those fluctuations. Another important feature, it is integral part of corporate planning. As we all know, a well-planned is half-done. Therefore, manpower planning is an important part of corporate planning because without a corporate plan, there cannot be a manpower planning. Optimum utilization of resources. This is the basic purpose of human resource planning because whatever we are planning, whether it is the requirement of the number or the type of employees, it is done to utilize the available resources. Here, the resources are the employees working in the organization. Therefore, in order to fully utilize their skills, we need to plan them. Next important feature is both qualitative and quantitative aspect. Quantitative and qualitative refers to the quality, that is the skills, the right number and the right type of employee required in the organization. It is in long and short term planning. This we will discuss it later, but in short I will tell you the long term planning is for the future prospect of more than 5 years, whereas short term planning is for a shorter duration or for a specific project. In human resource planning, the criteria is the term for which we are planning, because on the basis of the term we will define the future prospects of the employees. Next and the last important feature is it involves study of manpower requirement. This proves that the study of manpower availability, that is the database of the existing employees, and comparing it with the required number of employees in the organization. Next is objectives of human resource planning. As we have studied in detail about human resource planning, the basic objective regarding human resource planning is optimum utilization of the available employees. It helps to reduce imbalance in distribution and allocation of manpower in organization. It also ensures that the organization is well equipped with the required quantity and quality of manpower on a sustained basis. It helps to anticipate the impact of technology on jobs and resources. because on the basis of the technology we will be requiring our manpower. It helps to control the cost of human resource employed, used and maintained in the organization, because on the basis of planning we will further recruit or train the employees. It helps to provide a basis for management development programs. It ensures optimum contribution and satisfaction of the personnel with reasonable expenditure. Whatever we are planning according to the budget specified for human resources. And the last, to recruit and retain. Human resource planning is not only confined to recruiting the correct number and type of employees, it has another important feature of retaining the required quantity and quality, and to ensure that the employees does not leave the organization, which helps in fulfilling the requirement. Next, need for human resource planning. As we have discussed, human resource planning is an integral part. Without human resource, an organization cannot fulfill its objectives. Therefore, the first requirement of human resource planning is shortage of skills. When an organization is planning for the future prospects, say for about 5 years or more than 5 years, then they will be requiring skilled employees. Skilled employees are required to fulfill organizational goals and objectives. These days we find shortage of skills in the people, so it is necessary to plan for such skilled people much in advance than when we actually need them. Non-availability of skilled people when and where they are needed is an important factor which promotes sound human resource planning. Another need is frequent labor turnover. As we know, there are chances of employees being ambitious, being searching for better opportunities. Therefore, the turnover rate of employees in an organization has increased. Therefore, to meet the labor turnover, we require to plan human resources. Because frequent labor turnover is unavoidable by all means. Labor turnover arises because of discharges or marriages or promotions or getting a better opportunity, which causes a constant flow in the workforce in the organization. Another need is changing need of the technology. Due to changes in technology and new techniques of production, existing employees need to be trained or new blood injected into an organization. Therefore, on the basis of planning, we can find the correct type of employee who can work on the latest technology. It helps and is required to identify area of surplus or shortage of personnel. Further, we will study in the process of human resource planning that through human resource planning, we can easily identify the surplus or the shortage of employees. And on the basis of this, we can further plan our organization. It is required to bring change in organizational design and structure. Due to changes in organization structure and design, we need to plan the required human resource right from the beginning. Now, the another important aspect, that is the process of human resource planning. This is the most important part of every organization. As I have told you earlier, that organization is only fulfilling its objective through human resources. Without human resources, organization cannot perform and attain its goals. The planning process is affected by the overall organizational objectives and the situation of business. Human resource planning is primarily involved in forecasting human resource requirement, assessing human resource supply, and harmonizing demand supply factors through human resource related programs. As we know that there is an environmental changes, both internal and external, which helps in identifying organizational objectives and policies. And based on these environmental changes, the demand and supply is specified of human resources. In human resource planning process, the basic criteria is to meet the demand with the supply. The demand of the number and the type of employees required, and the supply of the existing employees in the organization, and then we compare the demand with the supply and find out whether there is shortage or surplus, and based on the shortage and surplus, we plan human resources, we implement the human resource planning, and we control the human resource planning. If we have surplus of employees in the organization, then the employees are required to give voluntary retirement schemes or they are laid off, depending upon the policy of the organization. But when there is shortage, we require to recruit and select new and required type of employees. Now the steps of human resource planning. The human resource planning process can be specified and divided into five steps, the first of which is assessing human resources. Assessing human resource with environmental analysis, under which we do political, economic, social and technological analysis and internal analysis of the objectives, resources and structure. This helps to find out the type and the number of employees, the requirement, the strength, the weaknesses and opportunities in an organization. Moreover, it includes an inventory of the workers and skills already available within the organization and the comprehensive job analysis. On the basis of assessing the number and the type of employees existing in the organization, the next step is demand forecasting. The forecasting is the process of estimating demand and supply for human resources in an organization. Demand forecasting is a process of determining future needs of employees in terms of quantity and quality. It is done to meet the future personnel requirements of the organization to achieve the desired level of output. And thus, this helps in future human resource need estimation with the help of organization's current human resource situation and analysis of organization plans and procedures. It will be necessary to perform a year-by-year analysis for every significant level and type of employees required. After finding out and assessing the existing employees, the next step is supply forecasting. This supply forecasting is entirely based on demand forecasting, because in human resource planning, we try to meet the demand with the supply. Supply is another site of human resource assessment. It is concerned with the estimation of supply of manpower given the analysis of current resources and future availability of human resources in the organization. It estimates the future course of human resources that are likely to be available from within and outside the organization. After finding out the demand and the supply, the next important step is we match demand with the supply. It is another step of human resource planning. It is concerned with bringing the forecast of future demand and supply of HR. The matching process refers to bring demand and supply in an equilibrium position so that shortages and overstaffing position will be solved. In case of shortage, an organization has to hire more required number of employees. And in case of surplus or overstaffing, it has to reduce the level of existing employees. Hence, it is concluded that the matching process gives knowledge about requirement and sources of human resources. And the last step is action plan. Action plan is entirely based on matching of the demand and supply. The action plan defines that, as I told earlier, that if there is a shortage, we need to hire. That means in action plan, we have to define the recruitment, the selection procedure, the selection test, and then conduct the selection and place the person at the required time at required place. And vice versa, if there is surplus of employees, then it requires to be sent on training, or it requires to retrench or lay off them and bring back whenever required. This is all about the process of human resource planning in the organization. Let us discuss about the last topic, that is the types of human resource planning. There are two types of human resource planning: short-term planning and long-term planning. Short-term planning, as the name itself suggests, it is for a shorter duration of time, that is for 1 or 2 years, or it is done for a specific project or assignment given to the organization. In this type of short-term planning, the organization need not put so much of efforts, but it is difficult to find the exact number and type of employees required. In short-term planning, it is concerned with the process of matching with the existing employees with their present job so that they can perform their job effectively. In short-term planning, we do not try to recruit new employees. We try to manage the planning based on the existing employees. We try to best fit the number and the type of employees we already have. But in order to have an efficient implementation of short-term planning, there are certain criteria to be studied. For example, the first is when the employee is less qualified as compared to the job specification, then what could be done? We can train the employees to improve the performance because it is for a shorter duration of time. And what else we can do is, if the job is not likely liked by the employee, we can change it. We can transfer and demote. And in case of responsible jobs, can assistance may be provided for the help. Another criteria is, sometimes the employees in short-term planning are more qualified than the requirement of that particular job or for that particular project. In that case, we can enlarge the job. That is, we can increase the scope, assign more responsibilities. Or what else we can do is, we can advise and counsel the employee, and we can place that employee an additional responsibility for a temporary basis. Next comes long-term planning. Long-term planning is the planning done for a longer duration of time. Longer duration means for more than 5 years, or I can easily say for 10 to 15 years. In long-term planning, it is based on permanent basis, and it is recruiting or placing the employees on a longer planning. Now, the following steps should be followed in long-term planning, which involves, first is projecting manpower needs. Now, this long-term planning is entirely based on the process of human resource planning, which we have studied earlier. It is similar because in manpower planning also we are planning for the future, forecasting the requirements and meeting the demand with the supply. Same is the case with long-term planning. The first step involved is projecting manpower needs. The first important step in long-term planning is to develop that organizational structure, what will be meeting the future manpower requirements in the best possible manner. The basic aim is to keep pace with the changes in future, and due to rapid technological advancement at present, it is not easy task to predict accurately the future job needs for the organization. Therefore, we should analyze in detail and project the manpower requirement. The second step is, we should make an inventory and analyze the manpower. Inventory means making a database of the existing employees, and the database should include the qualification, the skills, the experience, the specialization of every employee. And then we should analyze with what we are projecting for the manpower needs. If the manpower needs are fulfilled, then we can simply place the employee at the required place. But if the needs are not met and we require to recruit new employees, we should follow a long-term process of recruiting and selecting the right candidate required for the organization. And the last step, development and training of the employees. After selecting the exact number, the required number and type of employees, we should train them and develop them so that we can place whenever it is required. That's all for this session. Thank you so much.